The toxic oil syndrome of rapeseed disease was a massive poisoning in the spring of 1981 in Spain. The first case happened on the 1st May of the same year, and the 10th of June was discovered why it happened. Over 25,000 were intoxicated in a crowd of provinces, and around of 350 persons died. The first person who died was an 8-year child from Torrejón de Ardoz in Madrid. Initially, the disease that caused the death was called the legionary disease, but it expanded very fast around the Madrid community. And not only in Spain, the syndrome appeared also in countries like Denmark, France, which companies didn't admit it and tried to exempt their responsibility. 1.5 months after the first death, it was determined the truth of what had caused the poisoning: the adulterated rapeseed oil sold in bulk. After lots of investigations, a network of companies was discovered. These companies were involved in the alteration of the denatured oil. Late July, 7 companies and 10 brands were in the spotlight of the public health authority. The origin of the fraud was the mix that made some companies with the handling of the oil. They mixed a lot of different oil components, creating an oil with industrial uses. It was sold secretly and without any kind of control. These companies were ethically sick because they didn't apply three facts in their making decision process: the efficiency, the effectiveness, and the ethics. They had common purpose and means, but they skipped over moral and were not aware of what was right or wrong. Their performance was based only in efficiency and effectiveness, focusing on the achieve of benefits with lower costs. They just wanted to get profitability. That's why they totally forgot to implement the ethics as a very important point of the business decision. The people were final consumers, and it was made by people who had decided to manipulate the oil for their own benefits, even though it wasn't fulfilling any health measures. Therefore, in the making decision process of the involved companies, the integral approach should have been taken, which includes the ethics, because when we take decisions, we must be aware of the aspects related to the organization and the world outside. The right way to solve the damage would have been through the application of the three R's. In one hand, that means that the companies should have recognized that the oil was made for industrial process. On the other hand, they should have repaired and rectified their actions by the damage caused, with the corresponding compensations and the imprisonment of the main persons involved.
20 años sirven para olvidar?
No. Ni sirve para olvidar ni para perdonar.
Yo he notado que los más ricos nos han envenenado porque buscaban la mejor calidad y nosotros buscábamos lo más barato porque no teníamos tanto dinero como ellos.
Rabia no se olvida y no se perdona. Porque como que yo esté así, por unos que hayan querido hacer un trato o un negocio o lo que sea.
8 years after the death of the first poisoned, the justice accused 38 businessmen of the massive poisoning. From these 38 businessmen, only 13 were condemned of 20 years and 6 months of jail. The sentence was lower than the sentence that were required by the public prosecutor. He claimed for 8 of the defendants between 10,000 and 100,000 of years in jail. However, only 2 of the defendants were doomed with the enforcement of custodial penalties. 3 years later, the Supreme Court extended the sentence. They elevated the charges of some of the oil markers, but they declared insolvent because of the heavy indemnities. They demanded responsibility from the state for alleged negligence of their officials.